Hi, I am Maker Giovanni and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I will show you how I built some Christmas lights powered by a solar panel. Usually, if you want to put Christmas lights outdoors away from an outlet, and if you are not crazy like me using a 100 meter extension cord, the only choice is to use the battery powered ones. The huge problem with these lights is that after a short time the batteries run out, essentially becoming e-waste that is harmful to the environment and expensive for us. So I set out to find a more environmentally friendly solution. The first thing I thought was to integrate a rechargeable battery into the lights, so that I could charge them from a USB port, kind of like a power bank. But then I thought, why not also add a solar panel to charge the battery to make the lights completely autonomous? And so this project was born, some solar powered Christmas lights with even a system that switches them on and off automatically. Let's get started! This video is sponsored by JLCPCB. JLCPCB is a custom printed circuit board manufacturer that makes 1 to 8 layer PCB from as little as $2. JLCPCB provides everything you need to make your electronics project, starting from the EasyEDA electronic design software and going all the way to PCB production, component supply and stencil fabrication. In addition, JLCPCB offers a service for assembling the components on the PCB, which allows us to have it ready to use in our projects right away. JLCPCB is a great choice for making PCB of all kinds, because they also produce multi-layer PCBs at very low prices, with 6-layer PCBs starting as low as $35. Right now you can get a $30 coupon on 6-layer PCBs on the JLCPCB website, so you can try high-quality multi-layer PCBs for as little as $5. The idea behind this project is very simple. A solar panel charges a battery during the day, and when the evening comes, the lights turn on and run from the energy of the battery, which is then recharged the next day. These are the lights that we will modify to run on solar power. They are designed to run on 3 AA batteries, and we will see why this is important in a moment. The lights also have a built-in timer function, another thing that will come in very handy later. In addition to the lights, we need a solar panel. The panel should be able to produce more energy during the day than what the lights consume at night, even considering cloudy days. The panel I chose is rated for 5 watts and 18 volts, and should be more than enough to power our lights. Next we need a battery. Here I chose a 3.7 volts 18650 lithium-ion battery. Obviously, we cannot connect the battery to the solar panel directly, so I found this board with a CN3791 chip that allows us to charge the battery from the energy that is produced by the solar panel. This board promises to be an MPPT charge controller, which means it always runs the solar panel at maximum efficiency to get as much energy as possible. On the PCB, we have the main IC and some connectors to connect the battery and the solar panel. Alongside with the charge controller goes this tiny board, which is a battery protection circuit, which prevents the battery from over-discharging and protects it from short circuits. Regarding this, it is very important to remind that lithium-ion batteries can explode or catch fire in case of a short circuit or overcharge, so we should always be very careful when using them. To test the circuit, I inserted the battery into a 3D printed battery holder and connected the two terminals to the B- and B+ contacts on the BMS. Then I soldered the two leads from the charge controller battery connection to the center output terminals of the BMS. Lastly, I soldered the two core cable to the positive and negative of the solar panel and connected it to the input connector of the charge controller. As you have seen, the circuit is really simple. In any case, this is the schematic with all the connections. Before taking the solar panel outdoors, we need to build a stand on which to mount it. To do this, I designed some parts to be 3D printed. While the printer was making the parts, I cut to size a rectangular aluminum profile into which I drilled 4 6mm holes. At this point, I assemble the stand using M6 bolts to secure the different parts. As a last thing, I insert it into the center joint of the support a plastic conduit that will be used as a pole to hold up the solar panel. Now that everything is ready, the only thing missing is the sun. After 2 weeks of waiting, the sun finally arrived, and I took the solar panel outside. With the multimeter, I measured the current with which the solar panel charges the battery, which in full sunlight reaches almost half an ampere, much more than I expected. I also did a test with cloudy sky, and found out that unfortunately in this condition the current does not even reach 50 milliamperes. Now that the circuit that charges the battery is ready, we need to think about how to power our lights from the rechargeable battery. The lights I've chosen are designed to run on 3 AA batteries. In the battery holder, the batteries are connected in series, and since each battery produces around 1.5 volts, by multiplying 1.5 volts by 3, the lights receive a voltage of around 4.5 volts. This voltage is very close to the one of a lithium-ion battery, which reaches almost 4.2 volts when fully charged. This makes me think that we can connect the circuit of the lights directly to the battery, but the only way to find out is to try. First, I opened the battery holder of the lights and located on the PCB the positive and negative pads to which the batteries were connected. Then I drilled a hole in the battery holder, through which I inserted the 2-pin cable. I soldered the negative and positive of the cable to the 2 power inputs on the PCB of the lights. Between the 2 pins I also added a capacitor, because for the tests I did, without the capacitor the IC that controls the lights would sometimes get stuck. Now it was time to connect the 2 wires to the battery, press the button and it works! While I was at it, I also measured with the multimeter the current of the lights, which is around 40 mA. As I mentioned earlier, the lights have a built-in timer function, which from the moment we turn them on, keeps them on for 6 hours and off for the next 18 hours, and then repeats the cycle the next day. So, if in a day the lights are on for 6 hours with a power draw of 40 mA, we will have a total consumption of about 240 mAh. As we have seen, the energy production of the solar panel varies a lot if it is sunny or cloudy. For example, on a sunny day, the energy needed for the lights is produced in less than an hour, while if it is cloudy, it can take all day. Now that we know that the whole circuit works, we can turn the initial idea into something that looks more like a finished product. First, I designed a container to be 3D printed in which I could mount the battery, the charge controller and the BMS. For 3D printing, I chose some green PLA for the outer structure and gray for the part on which we will mount the electronics. My idea is to have an inner part that can slide inside the box, and then be secured with a screw. In this way, by mounting the box with the opening pointing down, we can protect the electronics from rain, which is very important since the solar panel will be placed outdoors. Also, in order to be able to secure it to a pole, the box has 2 spaces on the back to pass some zip ties. I started the assembly by putting an M3 threaded insert in the hole on the inner part of the box, which will then be used to attach it to the outer part with a screw. Then I salvaged 2 metal contacts from an old battery holder and soldered 2 wires to them. I glued the 2 contacts into the space for the battery in the 3D printed part. With double-sided tape, I also mounted the charge controller PCB. To connect the light to the battery, I will use this DC jack connector. First, I connected 2 wires to the positive and negative of the connector, and secured it with hot glue to the 3D printed part. Then I connected the positive and negative wires of the battery holder to the B- and B+ contacts of the battery protection circuit. Then I soldered the wires from the output connector and the 2 wires from the battery terminals of the charge controller to the center output terminals of the BMS. Lastly, I secured the BMS, and finally inserted the battery into the battery holder. Now we are left to connect the solar panel cable to the input of the charge controller, running it to the hole on the front panel. And so the electronic circuit is finished. The last thing to do is inserting the part with the electronics into the case and secure it with a screw. At this point, we just need to mount everything outdoors. Once everything was installed, I waited until the sunset and connected the lights to the battery. This way, thanks to the built-in timer, the lights will automatically turn on at the same time each day, and then turn off 6 hours later. Since I hooked them up, the lights have been running on solar power for about 2 weeks now without any problems, so I'd say they work great. Small parenthesis, if you are wondering how I made this nice time-lapse, I used an old smartphone and an ESP32 connected via Bluetooth that simulates a mouse pressing on the camera button every 5 minutes to take a picture. The individual photos are then merged into a video in post-production. And so this video ends here, and thank you very much for watching it until the end. If you are interested in electronics, check out my channel and maybe subscribe. Bye, and we'll see at the next video.